So is Holly talking to y'all again, or had the silent treatment worked so well the other night? No, she was going to keep it going.
She's talking to us now.
What's been? I imagine y'all practiced since that game. What did y'all? What was the effort level like in practice, and how do you think the intensity's been?
Well, I mean, we had practiced yesterday, but it was a little slower. We just kind of worked on the zone, worked on offense, obviously the day after a game. So it was actually a little slower, paid a lot more attention to detail. And so they actually didn't kill us like I think some of the fans might have expected. It was a lot more just working on the zone, attention to detail, stuff like that.
Andraya, what was your take on that and what Holly did? What did you think? What was your take on that whole thing?
Well, I mean, it doesn't really matter what my take was. She's the head coach, and she thought that would, you know, kind of motivate us or get us fired up, and it worked. So, obviously, we don't ever want her to have to do that again. I think it's kind of a shame that she had to do that as far as, you know, being so frustrated with our effort. You know, it's something that we don't want to happen again. So, hopefully, we'll keep that effort as she coaches us moving forward.
In terms of achieving that goal, what's the thing you players need to be mindful of then?
I think just playing hard. It's really not about, you know, even the coaches, even Dean at halftime and some of the other coaches, they're like, we don't care if the ball's going in. Obviously, you know, we're not shooting too well right now. We were just like, they just said, you know, we don't care if it's going in. We don't care if you make mistakes. We just kind of want you to have a heartbeat out there. We want you to play hard and have some emotion and some energy. And so I think it's just a matter of just bringing that out and just pulling together and playing hard collectively. I think that's what they want more than anything.
Virginia Tech's coming off a bad season, but they're off to a nice start this year, just beat Penn State. Have y'all seen much of them on film yet, or what do y'all know about them?
We haven't watched any film on them yet, obviously. You know, we played on Wednesday, had practice yesterday, and so we'll probably watch film on them today and tomorrow, and then maybe a little on Sunday, ready for the game.
You guys pressed a lot in full court. I mean, going into the year, what was the feeling in terms of how much you would employ that type of defense?
I think it just depends on the team. Obviously, some teams you're going to press and you're going to be up in them all the time, and then other teams you might not be able to, and so it just depends on the scouting report. But our coaches, they watch a ton of film and they figure out what's best for whatever team that we're playing, and that's what they thought was best for that game.
Is that playing that kind of defense, is that a good way to get, I mean, if there's a little lag in energy, is that a good way to get things going? Because that's hard to play, but it's also very high tempo.
I think so. It's tough, but it's definitely high tempo. And then obviously we got a few chances just to get some easy baskets, some steals and some layups and some steals and and-ones. And I think those are high energy plays that I think get you going, as opposed to just kind of running back, setting up your defense, being a little more stagnant. I think that's kind of energy that might kind of drain you a little bit. But when you're up and you're going and everything like that, I think it helps the tempo a lot.
As a team, y'all were able to make a few three-pointers toward the end of the game the other night after starting slow. Is there any hope, any confidence that maybe y'all have kind of gotten over that three-point slump?
I think it'll come, but regardless, you know, we just have to keep shooting, taking good shots and quality shots, I think. And I think it'll fall. You know, hopefully it'll fall at the right time, and we'll all start hitting shots when we need to.
You guys lost those three seniors last year, and so there's been kind of a change internally here in terms of leadership amongst the group. How's that kind of working out, do you feel like, right now with this group?
I think it's working out fine. You know, Holly has definitely, you know, chosen some leaders, the team have picked some leaders have emerged, and really we all just have to lead, and you can lead in so many different ways, just by leading by example or just doing the best you can out there. And then, you know, there are certain vocal leaders, and I think sometimes you have to lead, sometimes you have to follow, and it's really just team dynamics that have developed and that will continue to develop as we move forward.
Who are the vocal? Who's kind of assumed that role, do you feel like?
I think Jordan and me, and then Bashar has stepped up vocally as well, so which has been huge for her, and just a total maturity and in her game and just in herself. So I think us three, we've been identified as the vocal leaders, but really a lot of people step up and talk and communicate or voice their opinions and say what's going on, and we all just have to work on listening and hearing each other.